Hello guys, in this video I'm gonna show you how to turn your photo like this into this passport size photo and then arrange them in this fashion so that you can get a print of them. So let's dive into the video to see how this can be done. First you need to go to File, Open, and from here you can bring in a photo that you want to turn into a passport size photo. I'll click Open. So that is the photo that we'll work on. First, let me duplicate this photo by pressing Ctrl J. Let me turn off the visibility of the bottom layer, and now we will work over the top layer. Now go into your toolbar, and you need to enter 1.5 inch into 2 inch size, and here we will enter 300 resolution. Now just hold from any side, crop your photo in such a way that shoulders on both sides are equal, photo is centered, and when everything is okay, press this check mark and here we go. Again, we'll duplicate this photo by pressing Ctrl J and turn off the bottom layer. Let's zoom in to see our photo closely. First, we have to remove its background. For this, we can go to Tool section, and here we will use Quick Selection tool. In this way, you can just select background which you want to remove. But if you look closely, you can see also part of the body has been selected which we don't want. So press Alt from your keyboard and just drag on the body like this. Similarly, you can see ear has been included in the section, so we will remove them like this. Now when your selection is ready, just press Delete from your keyboard and the background will be deleted. And here we go. Now press Ctrl D to deselect it. Click on this bottom layer and now create a new layer, and you can see this layer is at the bottom of that photo that we are working on currently. We want to change its background to blue, so just pick up a blue color from here, go to Paint Bucket tool and click, and here we go, background of the photo is changed. So after changing the background, we want to give this photo a formal look. For this, we need to bring in a dress. We'll go to File, click on Open, Desktop, and here I have a few photos. I'll choose one of them. Now just hold this photo like this, go to your photo and leave it over here. And here we go. But you can see it is behind the photo. So from the layer panel, just grab it and bring it up, bring it down, and from your keyboard press Ctrl T to transform it. Now you can use a shift key so that you can change its size proportionately, but you can also work around just by holding from one side and dragging it like this. Just adjust it. And when you think it's okay, let me zoom in to show you. Just look closely so that everything is okay. It seems to me that it's still needs some workaround. So Ctrl T again, and I'll adjust it from this side as well. Okay. Now it seems to me that it's pretty okay. So I'll click this check mark. Now you can see our photo looks pretty good, but here on the shoulders you can see the part of the photo, it's giving pretty unpleasant look, so we'll remove it. For this, we can go to lasso tool, choose this lasso tool. We will select this part of the photo from the shoulder, just click and hold and then close it, press Delete, and here we go. Similarly, you can select this part of the photo and then press Delete and it would be gone. Press Ctrl D to deselect, and now our photo is almost ready. Since this photo has already got a very clean face, but if you have a photo where you can see some acnes like this, then you can remove these acnes as well, or other black spots on the face. Let me show you how this can be done. Just grab spot healing brush from here, increase its size. Let me zoom in closely. Spot healing brush, click, and you can see you can just remove these acnes or black spots from the face like these. In this way, these acnes, black spot or blemishes can be removed from the face so that it looks good. Now just compare both photos. You can see all the acnes are gone. One more thing that I would like to show you is how to increase or decrease light on your face. Just pick up a photo, go to image, adjustments, and here we can go to curves. You can see this particular photo has got too much light on its face. You can just work around over here so that it looks natural. Now you can see, let me click OK, and here we go. Let me show you. You can see this one looks pretty natural. Let me zoom in to show you some of the part of the photo that are still that still needs to be worked on. Here you can see some of the part of the background is still there. For this, you can just go to eraser tool and remove these parts like these. You can see you can remove these part like this. Now we will select all these layers. Just press Ctrl from your keyboard and click on this layer. Again, select this layer as well by pressing Ctrl and clicking. Now you can right click and merge these layers. Now all these layers have been merged. Let's zoom out a little bit. In order to create a border around this photo, we will first select this photo by pressing Ctrl A. Then we can go to Select, Modify, Create a Border. And if you click OK and then press Delete, a border will be created around this photo. But there is another method which I would like to show you as well. Again, select the photo, Ctrl A, go to Edit, Stroke, give a 10 pixel, change the color to white, press OK, and here we go. We have created a very good white border around this photo. Now you can just save this photo and print it as a single photo. But if you would like to get more than one copy of the photo, then here is the solution. Just go to Edit, and here we have Define Pattern option. Click over it. Let me name it Sajid. Click OK. And let me open a new document, New. And from here, I will choose this 4:6 portrait. Click. Let me rotate it at 90 degree. Image rotation, 90 degree. And again, I'll go to Edit. Click on Fill. From here, you will go to the photo that you have just created, which is this one. I will click OK, and here we go. All your photos are ready now. Now you can go to File, Export it as a quick PNG, or you can also Save As. Click Save As, save on your computer, give it a name, and from here you can choose the file type. Let me choose this JPG on desktop. Click Save, and we'll give it a high quality. Press OK, and here you can see these are your photos which can be printed on any printer now. I hope you have learned something new in this video. Please don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.